Hello friends, today we are going to learn about the topic Programming Support for Google App Engines, in which we are going to learn what are the programs they are there which helps or which supports the Google APIs or Google App Engines. Programming Support for Google App Engine. What Google App Engine is? Google App Engine or GAE is a platform as a service. That means we all know Google App Engine, we mostly use it. Then we use it to deploy it. We use it to access the applications which are of our use. What Google App Engine is? It is a platform which is there for the users to create their own applications, to deploy the applications created by them, because it provides an independency, the basic infrastructure independency, or we could say the platform independency to the users. So it is a platform as a service, cloud-based web hosting service on Google's infrastructure. For an application to run on Google App Engine, it must comply with Google's platform standards, which narrows the range of applications that can be run and severely limits those applications' probability. See, it has certain kinds of, for example, any of the companies, say, for example, I have a company or I am a teacher, so I will be teaching a lot of subjects, but it is related to my stream, the things which I know, which I can understand, and for which I can give knowledge to the students. So in a similar way, when we are talking about Google App Engine, it serves as platform as a service, but to a limit or to a certain extent. That means if an application has to run on Google App Engine, then it must comply with Google's platform standards, which narrows or which limits the range of application that can be run and severely limit those applications' probability or portability, we could say. That means it cannot then certainly, since it is here running or deploying on the Google App Engine, and then at certain time on suddenly it moved to the another platform or another platform as a service, so it limits that application's portability, that it should be there for certain time. And if it goes to another platform, then it has to have some of the changes or some of the limitations as per the another platform as a service. Google App Engine, it supports certain features or some of the following major features, which is, first one, dynamic web services based on common standards, then automatic scaling and load balancing, then authentication using Google's account API, that is application programming interfaces, persistent storage with query access sorting and transaction management features, then task queues and task scheduling, then a client-side development environment for stimulating or simulating Google App Engine on your local system, and then one of either two runtime environments. That means either one of two runtime environments should be there, which is Java or Python. Google file system. Now we know Google App Engine, it has certain things, certain features. What Google file system is, abbreviated as GFS, a global file system, is a cluster file system that enables a cluster of computers to simultaneously use a block device that is shared between them. See, we all know in cloud computing we use shared pool of resources, and there is multi-tenancy in cloud computing architecture, any of the cloud computing architecture. So when we are talking about this Google file system, it supports the storage in file format. We have seen in OpenStack that it supports two type of storage, that is object storage and block storage. The third type of storage, that is file system storage, is supported by this particular file system. So here, this global file system, what it do? It is a cluster file system. Cluster means a group of computer or cluster of computers that enable the cluster of computers to simultaneously, that means at the same time, since they are tenant to the same shared pool of resources, so they can access those resources simultaneously at the same time, and it uses the block device which is being shared between them. GFS reads, that means Google file system reads and writes to the block device like a local file system, but also allows the computers to coordinate their input output to maintain file system consistency. Then with Google file system, any changes that are made to the file system on one computer will immediately be seen on all other computers in that cluster. That means if there is a change made in this particular number one computer, then there will be change in the this. That means all the computers connected to that cluster or present in that cluster, the change will be seen there. Google file system provides fault tolerance, reliability, scalability, availability, and performance to large networks and connected nodes. Google file system is made up of several storage systems built from low-cost commodity hardware components. It is optimized to accommodate Google's different data use and storage needs, such as its search engine, which generates huge amounts of data that must be stored. Big tables and Google NoSQL system is the another thing in Google App Engine. See, Google Cloud Bigtable is a productized version of NoSQL database that stores Google's bits and bytes. That means all the data or information which is being stored is with this Google Cloud Bigtable. And it has this NoSQL version or NoSQL database. The big selling point is it does not require the maintenance traditionally needed for compatible on-premise SQL or NoSQL solutions. That means when in cloud, this database, that is NoSQL, it does not need what maintenance, that means continuous maintenance, which the traditional databases which is using this type of NoSQL needed when it is on premise. Bigtable is a compressed high performance and proprietary data storage system built on Google file system, Chubby lock service, and a few other Google technologies. Bigtable maps two arbitrary string values, that is row key and column key, and timestamp hence three-dimensional mapping into an associated arbitrary byte array. It is not a relational database and can be better defined as a sparse, distributed multi-dimensional sorted map. See, we all know what databases are used in this particular cloud computing. So when we are talking about certain specific vendors who are providing cloud computing services, they must also be using this distributed databases type. So here, this distributed multi-dimensional database is present, and it is defined as a sparse, the relational database, and this relational database, it is distributed multi-dimensional type, and it is known as sparse. Bigtable is designed to scale into the petabyte range across hundreds or thousands of machines, and to make it easy to add more machines to the system and automatically start taking advantage of those resources without any reconfiguration. Now, Google's distributed log service known as Chubby. Chubby is a distributed log service intended for coarse-grained synchronization of activities within Google's distributed systems. Chubby has become Google's primary internal name service. It is a common rendezvous mechanism for systems such as MapReduce, the storage system GFS, and Bigtable use Chubby to elect a primary from redundant replicas, and it is a standard repository for files that require high availability, such as access control lists. Chubby is a relatively heavyweight system intended for coarse-grained logs, logs held for hours or days, not seconds or less. Thank you.